Hello, everybody. This is Miles Luigi. Welcome you back to Let's Play Mario Gives Up 2. It's come to my attention. That was a red level. The thing is, it was a big train level. There's not much room for deviation in linear train levels. But despite that, I'm going to have Luigi take an exploration of the level and figure out where the secret exit is. One moment, please. Aha! Hidden where no one would ever look! Inside of a train car! So if we hide inside of a train car, wait for the train to derail and cause a whole bunch of chaos, that brings us to Land of the Dead 5. So it looks like today, we're probably going to take care of a ghost house and Land of the Dead 5. Which I believe should get us our final hints. So we'll be able to finally enter hell once we actually make it that far in the game. For until then, we have to take on a spooky frozen ghost house, and look at that crazy background go! Watch the crazy background really go as Mario gets slobbered by a green blob. The green blob basically just consumes him like a single-celled organism consumes another single-celled organism. Munch! You had to have noticed that, right? Here we go. So what happens, you have a ghost house which was abandoned, you know, ghosts are living in it, now you have a frozen ghost house. Do booze and eeries feel temperature? Which is a funny thing to ask, because whether you feel hot or cold is actually a measurement of how much heat is leaving or entering your body, not a measure of how hot or cold things are. If you need proof of that, try touching a cold book and then try touching a cold pan at the exact same temperature. The pan will feel colder because the pan actually transfers more heat away from you than the cold book does. We're basically talking about thermal conductivity, which is actually how your body, you know, measures temperature, at least internally, whether you feel things as hot or cold. Oh god, green blob coming in and away from me. Oh gosh, I might have to take a hit to get through all this. Jump! Okay, just gotta jump over the hole in the ground, here we go. But yeah, here we go, midway point. But yeah, you could frankly be in contact with something that's boiling hot, but it doesn't feel that hot because it doesn't actually transfer that much heat into you. While on the other hand, you could be touching something that's, say, only 20 degrees Fahrenheit hotter than you are, but because it transfers all that heat extremely quickly, it feels burning hot, and the background stopped moving. I don't know if that's a sign of something spooky to come, or if, you know, the background was set to a tiling pattern, and I just fell down the floor. Mario, you noticed that hole going around the floor? You didn't have to jump into it. See, now you're falling perpetually down into nowhere. Hope you had a good life. Yeah. Bye-bye, Mario. Alright, get on the safety platform. Matter of fact, let me just rush through this area. Wow, did I get lucky. Oh man, it's just like, this is a difficult section in the game. You wanna know what my advice is? Run! Just get through it as fast as freaking possible. That way, if you take a hit, you're able to get in there and get out of there as soon as possible. Here we go. Damn it, Eeries. It's funny, the Eeries actually have that movement pattern of a Medusa head, if you've ever actually noticed and thought of. Wow. I could really use a widescreen Super Mario World so I can see crap like that coming ahead. Back to the midway point. Alright, okay. Rush through things. Hope the line of booze don't. Okay, line of booze reappeared last time I did this, so don't reappear, please. Thank you. Well, we've made it. Did I really, once again, die just before the next pipe? That's just becoming a reoccurrent theme now, and it's really annoying. We have the really long line of booze that's going to be really difficult to jump over. You know, we got to use the big long jump. Long jump! Into a hole. Well, this could take me a little while, understandably so. With a big line of booze, it's honestly better to not even bother trying to jump over them. Instead, just, you know, find the safe spot, duck underneath them. Yeah, we'll go with that. Oh, I did it! For those of you who just watched it, I have no idea how godly long fast forward that was. I didn't cheat on that boss. Yeah, I did it. Woohoo! You might be wondering, why didn't you cheat on that boss? That took you however long that took me. I actually don't even know. On, off stuff. Before we go to Land of the Dead 5, let me explain why. That boss battle, despite being as difficult as it was, felt fair. Like, fair, stupidly difficult. Like, every death felt like it was my fault. It didn't feel like, say, the stupid friggin' Nyan Cat level, or going back to Mario Gives Up 1, that stupid oil barrel, where it felt like I wasn't in control of my situation. With that said, we're about to go into a stupidly difficult level called Land of the Dead number 5. So our final number is the number 3. Ah, boy, looks like we're in another city, and good to know the water doesn't freeze me to death. I'm not telling you! It's not worth it! The monsters and stuff like that in town leave now, I really don't care. So, what a horrible night to have a curse! Oh god, this level is silly. Really silly! Is that a Goomba with a shower cap on? Wow! Holy crud. What a horrible night to have a curse. You just invaded a town, Luigi, where the people here just got done taking showers, decided to go outside and realized, oh shit, that's right, I live in northern Mario World where it's extremely cold! At least I don't have to deal with the stupid Mushroom Kingdom's laws, because, you know, we live north of the Mushroom Kingdom, which is its own country. I'm trying to make a Canada joke in case you couldn't tell. Oh, okay, thank goodness that pipe is in trouble. I thought, come on, pipe, go in. But, okay, shower caps on enemies, that's funny, and wow, okay. Well, go get your springboard before the enemies jump out of their windows with their shower caps. I apologize if I'm seeing this wrong and it's not actually Goombas with shower caps on, but that's what I'm seeing. I mean, you've known people who just are really nasty after they get out of the shower, and there's a super fast bullet bill launcher over there, but it's, you know, I was taking a shower and the temperature got really cold, and it's like, well, this is what you get for taking a warm shower when you live in a cold area. But I took a cold shower to wake up. It works better than a cup of coffee. I mean, Joe, it's like, I don't even want to listen to this anymore. Now I have two springboards. Well done, Miles Luigi. But what exactly? Oh, wait, I know what I can do with two springboards. Oh, fudge. Those enemies are going to fall on my head. Yep. Okay, so here's what I need to do. I need to just wait. Wait. All right. There we go. Oh, that was one of the enemies. Great, there's another enemy. All right, gotta wait for the other enemy. Come on, come down. Over here. Ah, oh, damn it. Okay, come on. I know you're up there. Well, all right, well, I guess he's gonna ambush me. Maybe he doesn't want to ambush. Wow, okay. There's a stupidly fast third tier promoted bullet bills flying all over the place. Damn it. Speaking of things, Luigi, when was the last time you took a shower? It's been a while. You've been on adventure with Mario so long, you probably smell worse than you do after a day of plumbing in the sewers. And just as I say that, you know, you just decided to land on some spikes without your spike mail. It was really dumb. Yeah, that is a dangerous jump. Warning, you may want to bring lots of power-ups into this level, because, I mean, you got the third tier promoted bullet bills. This is death, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Bullet bills and angry Goombas and Monty Moles who just got done taking their showers. Yeah, that was not a brilliant idea of you to go here, Luigi. Alright, up top. That way none of them can hit ya. Oh, that one? Okay, off screen. Now it can't hit ya anymore. Those things might as well fire lasers. Alright, there's something down here. Yep. If you live here, you really want to be only as tall as a Goomba or a Monty Mole with all those stupid bullets flying all over the place. No wonder there's only Goombas and Monty Moles. And, of course, the haunted piranha plants. That level was stupidly silly. Velele 18! Hooray! For the final hint. So, After all is said and done, I have no idea how long that buoy battle took me, so I don't know if this is actually going to be a short video, but to help things out, we're going to go ahead and take a look at that hint. And on the next episode of Let's Play Mario Gives Up 2, we are going to go ahead and take care of all the on-off stuff. So prepare me for a massive castle where we have more rotating blocks that drive me nuts. Time for our final hint. First off, I'm in the correct directory. Right? Yep, we gotta go to hints. All right. Unzip 5. Come on, I can type. And the password is Vele18. Here we go. CD5. Cat. Int 5. I think less. Int 5. There. Not only that, now we can click on the link. It's a YouTube link as expected. And the final Mario Gives Up 2. Hint 5. Video load. It's a 12-second video. Come on. There we go. The final letter, 3. Here's our hint. What is this hell? What the hell is this? Oh. Jump down bottom, click it, feather. Well, doesn't look like we're going to need definitely the secret to find something, but this is good to know. All right. For the final hints, let's take a look at these comments. Password to hell. Well, cool. I don't have to put it together unless this guy's trolling. Are you trolling NZSF150? You commented a year ago. It'd be funny if you saw this. I'm like, holy crap, where was I a year ago? I was commenting on Mario Gives Up 2 hint videos. All hints achieved. Yes. That about does it. This has been Miles Luigi. See you all next time.